The highly anticipated launch for the Artemis SLS rocket launch, well, it's been scrubbed. Unfortunately, our Glenn Glazer at the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral. Glenn, disappointing news for so many people. You've been up there so early this morning. So fill us in. What's the vibe out there?
I mean, all around it is, to put it bluntly, it's just a bummer. I mean, everybody was very excited about this mission. People who watched the Apollo missions back in the late 60s, early 70s, they couldn't wait to see us in another rocket off and an attempt to start the process to put people back on the moon again. I know my kids were so excited about this launch today. They even asked Mom if they could stay home today from school. She was like, no, you got to go, but we'll record it for you. But honestly, everything looked pretty good. There were a number of delays early on with the entire launch today with the SLS, the Space Launch System rocket. At first, there was trouble fueling the rocket because there was lightning offshore early this morning. Then the Orion space capsule, which sits on top of the rocket, that spaceship had some problems with communications between the ground crew and the actual capsule itself. So then that was an issue that they managed to solve. Then they thought there might be a crack in one of the tanks because they saw a frost line there. That turned out to be just a crack in some foam. So they actually were happy about that it wasn't anything dangerous. But in the end, it was what's called an engine bleed that caused the scrub. And an engine bleed is when the engines recycle, they start to cycle the hydrogen a bit in order to prep it for takeoff, and each engine does that separately. Three of the engines were cycling the hydrogen properly to prepare it for takeoff, for liftoff. One engine was not, engine number three. Those four engines, the RS-25 engines, they're at the bottom of the rocket there, are all recycled from the Space Shuttle program, as well as the solid rocket boosters on either side of the SLS rocket. So there's a lot of recycled parts in there. They're going to try to fix it over the next few days here, and the next potential launch window is on Friday. One thing that will be very telling is if they actually leave the SLS out on the launch pad, or if they make the crawler transport unit, which it sits on, go all the way back into the VAB, the Vehicle Assembly Building. If they end up having to take it back in the building, that means it's something pretty major that they'll have to work on inside, that it's something they can't fix out there on the launch pad, in which case it most likely will not be on Friday, but it'll be at a launch date after that. So we'll watch that to see if that happens. Hopefully it will get to launch on Friday, because I know so many people really want to see it go, but as is the case with anything like this, better safe than sorry. So that's the way we're looking right now. We got our fingers crossed for Friday, though. I'll send it back to you in the studio.
Thanks so much. Great reporting. Crossing fingers. Now, who's not too far from him, let's send it to our Caleb Califano, joining us live right now from the Treasure Coast. Caleb, good morning to you. I know a lot of people were excited to see that launch there in Vero Beach.
Yeah, we were all excited here, and to add insult to injury, we're now getting some weather here, so we apologize if it affects the shot in any way, but if you see behind me, an hour ago, this boardwalk was pretty filled with people excited to see the Artemis 1 finally launch into the sky. They tell me this spot right here on the Treasure Coast, right here in Vero Beach, is one of the busiest spots. It's also one of the best spots to see those rockets go up into the sky. Obviously, though, with this cancellation, people are very understanding. They know the engineers know what they're doing, and the next time the Artemis 1 is ready to go, they'll be back here at the boardwalk. We saw so many people here, though, this morning, from young to old, everything in between. We talked to one man who remembers during the start of the space race and Sputnik 1 went up into the air, and we saw the opposite of that. We saw one little boy who's 9 years old, and this was his first rocket he was going to see. He says he's disappointed, but he's also excited for the future.
I'm feeling kind of excited because it's just like they're going to the moon again, and it's really cool to see something like that.
People tell us the next time the Artemis 1 is going to head up to the sky, they will be back here on the boardwalk, but right on time, the rain's starting to fall down on us, so we're going to send it back to you.
Right, get dry. Thank you so much. Thanks for standing out there this morning. Our Josie Carbonari, she's live at Limestone Creek Elementary. Josie, this launch special for fifth grade teacher there, I'm sure she's a little disappointed this morning too. Good morning.
Good Good morning. So that teacher disappointed and her fifth grade students. So this was very special for Miss Kenny. She knows personally one of the people involved in the Artemis 1 mission, specifically the lead flight director at NASA. So she's been in touch with him and his wife all morning long there at the Kennedy Space Center this morning. So as soon as we heard that the flight was completely scrubbed, there was just a bunch of disappointment in the kids' faces, unfortunately. But she says that even though this mission has been canceled, once it does happen, she hopes this experience and lessons taken away stays with her students for a lifetime.
He's excited. The team's ready to go. They're laser focused in, and they're hoping for a successful launch so that they can then progress to the next level, which will be a manned mission down the road. I can remember back in the day watching the Apollo missions when I was sitting in a classroom. So I'm hoping that they will remember this and it'll be extra special for them with you all here.
And we were, of course, invited back once the launch is rescheduled. So we'll be back here at some point, hopefully by Friday, to see the launch with the fifth grade students here at Limestone Creek Elementary. Reporting live from Jupiter, I'm Josie Carbonari, WPBF 25 News.